NHANES is a combination of, I think it's the space shuttle for NASA and sort of the circus. We pull into town for 9 weeks, and you hope during those nine weeks that the IT runs and it operates and you have no issues. But much like NASA, we're running experiments that are vitally important, and you've got to keep everything collected and on time. So it's an interesting combination of two different worlds, I think, and it's just a lot of fun.
Every 6 to 8 weeks, you're traveling from one part of the country to another. You see places in the world that you would never think of going on vacation.
If you look at it, it's been around for 50 years now. That's amazing. And it's gone through many, many iterations.
We usually go and talk to the public health people in the area and some of the county officials, asking them where would they think the best place to have the survey located. So there's a real process that has to go on to try to find a site.
So each of our NHANES mobile exam centers is made up of four customized semi-truck trailers, and they have to be parked very specifically. They have to be parked a certain distance apart, and once they're parked, you can pull out the passageways and connect the entire thing together.
Basically, if someone is examined in the morning, we have the capability of seeing that data, you know, by the afternoon, almost in real time.
In one program, we had a hurricane, an earthquake, we had a tornado, an ice storm, and flood. And the program ended up on time and under budget.
I think that the survey over the years has developed, you know, probably models and ways of going about doing a survey.
The nutrition data are critical not only to the American public, but also to the setting of national standards for food programs, school meals, for looking at obesity trends, for looking at setting nutrition standards for the population.
We would have never had the ability to continue to monitor trends over time, looking at some of these public health issues that can either only or best be studied using direct physical measures. So unless you have the ability to do that and look at direct physical measures, you just won't be able to assess those particular public health issues. Well, the biggest challenge is always just financially and administratively. It's always a challenge to keep the survey going. It's not easy to do. It's also very hard to meet the needs of so many, if you will, collaborators, customers, and users.
I think the biggest challenges were trying to work with federal agencies and try to prioritize and maximize the content of the survey.
The hardest challenges were finding the time for our really terrific analysts to do the analysis of the survey data.
One time, three people, the whole team quit after vacation. No one came back. So I had to go out there, and I was the lab team for a whole stand in New York.
There has been times like in New York, and they wouldn't allow us to drive the trailers over this bridge because they felt the bridge was not sturdy enough. So we went and put them on a barge, floated them up to the site, and then lifted the trailers off to the site using a crane.
We didn't have networks like you do now. You didn't have Wi-Fi. Everything was hardwired. So even though that person had now collected this information on their computer, we were taking disks, floppy disks, and transporting them to the remote offices. So it was really rudimentary, but it was, quote, state of the art at that time. And of course, things now have changed drastically.
And that's the one thing I think that the program does. It does keep learning, and it keeps learning what, you know, what's the best things to do.
Between 1994 and 98, the world had changed. And I think in many ways, it was a harder sell for, and this was true across many different studies, that response rates were dropping because the public was becoming more concerned about issues related to privacy. There were more concerns raised in the press about research, biomedical research in general, and it was just a harder sell. But the staff were great. There was a tremendous responsiveness to the challenge. I think everyone saw it as a real challenge.
Well, we have this difficulty with being out in the field and running in three different locations at the same time, and as we like to say, a 7x18 operation. We run 18 hours a day, 7 days a week, in three different time zones, usually. We also are running pilots for the next two-year cycle while we're collecting data, while we're producing data for the public. So all of this work is going on at the same time, and trying to produce new components and new software and keeping up with technology, it keeps us busy and grays our hair, and we lose a little bit at the end of the day.
I think at the time, getting the lead out made us all very proud, and it was so enlightening and made changes.
When we got into the lead data, it was stunning. The fact was that the prevalence of high blood lead levels was higher than anyone in the country had anticipated. The lead came out of gasoline in the U.S. basically because of the NHANES data.
Looking back on it, I was really shocked that we weren't collecting smoking data, either in NHANES or the Health Interview Survey at the time, because it was basically too political to dabble in. It wasn't until after we had been here a few years, thanks to Ron Wilson and a few folks like that, that we started to collect data on tobacco use.
Some contributions that have come out of the NHANES program. One is the dietary reference intakes that are the basis for so many nutrition policies, from food labeling through the food assistance programs. And these couldn't be done without the contributions that the NHANES program makes.
And certainly today, the NHANES program or the NHANES data on obesity are what are used by every expert committee, the Institute of Medicine. It is the tracking mechanism as to are we making progress or not.
And I think one of the major contributions to public health and to people in a very real way was the growth charts, the NCHS growth charts. And it's something that anyone can relate to, you know, because everybody who's ever had a child knows that their child's been sooner or later plotted on the growth chart.
The folate data we finally got out, that's another wonderful example of where we've affected the whole U.S. population, because now folate is in bread products. It's in various types of products at a certain level. And folate levels have actually gone up. The fact is, that was from NHANES. It came from NHANES.
The survey itself has gone through a tremendous progress in technology. In fact, when I started in the 70s, everything was done by pencil and paper.
I think one of the major accomplishments in this time period was taking data from NHANES 3 and producing public data sets in about 3.5 years. And if you look at the continuous NHANES, we were able to produce data in 18 months, and now we're down to about 9 months, and eventually we'll get down, hopefully, to about 6 months. So that cycle of being able to produce very high-quality data in very short time periods, I think that's probably the most significant achievement with respect to IT.
Now we're down to the fact that we can get data out in about 6 to 9 months, depending on the data file and whether or not it needs to be sent to a laboratory for processing.
When a study is well run and adequately supported, you can do first-rate science, even in the face of a changing world and changing perceptions in the community. But it requires that you be aggressive and thoughtful and creative. And I think all of those characterize the NHANES staff very well.
Well, personal, private, or public?
The best times, I think, has always been just working on the NHANES. I can't think of any morning that I have not woken up and been happy to go to work.
It was a great job. It was a great job for me, and it was mainly because it was never boring. There was always things to do, either on the operations side or the analytics side.
The fact of the matter is this program is so unique that it's one of the things I think that kept a lot of people staying here for a long, long time.
People were great here. I spent 17 years here. It was the best professional and work experience. It was a real team approach to planning, working out problems, a lot of opportunity to work with people trained, different backgrounds, different disciplines.
We all always are very competitive when it comes to the picnics and other challenges that don't have anything to do with our surveys, but that just those are probably the best memories I have, are of the people working together for a common goal, whether it's to collect the data or to actually do a holiday party or do the win the egg toss.
Our branch, I was in the health examination field operations branch, and these two gentlemen were in the psychological statistics branch, which was across the hall, and we'd all have lunch together, and we, in fact, we were a group called, and I have a picture of this, of you all, called Friendly and the Statisticians, a rock band.
It's always a fun story, always an adventure on the road with NHANES. There's always something to tell. People who've worked on NHANES for a while could probably write very entertaining books, because something is always happening that you wouldn't really expect.
I still don't remember hiring a yes person. There were no people who would just take what I thought and say, what a wonderful idea. No. Always discussion, and always better. Always better.
I think probably one of the best memories is when I think it was Dave who said to me, he said, you really don't understand this unless you go out and take an exam. And it was going through that exam that was an eye-opener. One, I had never realized how tight the trailers were.
Eddie was sort of our media advisor. I remember one thing he told me to do was make sure you're wearing calf-high stockings when you're on television, because otherwise your socks are going to fall down and you look funny when you cross your legs, that sort of thing. So I took his advice. I didn't know what I was doing. I went out and bought stockings like that, and darned, I wasn't on television. These things started sliding down my leg. I said, jeez, you know.
Well, I think my most cherished memory is what a fabulous team we had. Everybody just was so enthused about the work that we were doing.
What makes it really special is the people, and I think that's because people who want to make a difference and do well are attracted to be part of this program, and even one time in their life. Many people come and go and don't stay there as long as I have. I'm one of the few crazies who stay that many years, but people come and go, and all of them have made a difference if you look back over time. That it keeps going, that there's another 50 years, and that 50 years from now, what I would say about those brilliant people who in 1957 and 8 planned this survey in such a way that we're still using almost all of the same techniques and procedures, we just became more sophisticated, that 50 years from now, people will be saying, we're still doing the same thing that Cliff and his staff did at this point in time, but just using new technologies and new information.
As I'm sure, I hope that everybody who's ever involved with the survey hopes it can go on, because there certainly has been a tremendous amount of good.
My birthday wish for the next survey is that we have all new trailers.
That we get new lab trailers.
Birthday wish for our 50th. Well, endless amounts of money, so we can continue data collection. And I think, you know, on a personal level, I'd really like to see NHANES doing, having a much broader and bigger vision for what we can do.
I would like to see NHANES well-funded, and I think we may see that.
My wish is what they, and when I left, they had really begun to accomplish, and that was publishing data within 6 months.
I think, just for my, a happy birthday type of thing to NHANES, I think the current staff needs to be congratulated for carrying on the rich tradition that has been established.
The Spanish have a toast that's health, wealth, happiness, and the time to enjoy them. So for Hanes on its 50th birthday, I would say maintain the focus on health. I would hope and wish that you have the funding to continue this outstanding program, that you have a happy team, as we were, and the time in which to do all this important work.
I'd certainly like it to continue, as always, because I think it's such valuable information.
I wish that Hanes could have ample funding so that the actual survey could collect the information it needs and get the information out without always being so concerned about, is there going to be ample funding to keep the survey in the field every year?
You get the recognition that you deserve for being an integral, necessary part of the biomedical and public health infrastructure of this country. And that means having a commitment of support from this country to this resource.
Oh, happy birthday, NHANES. 50 more, definitely 50 more years.